3 games remain for the SDSU football team, and the Jackrabbits sit at 5-4 overall and 2-3 in the Missouri Valley Football Conference after losing 37-17 at top-ranked North Dakota State on Saturday inside the Fargo Dome.
Disappointed that we handled some things and didn't handle some others. It's not like they came out and did some things differently in the second half. We couldn't stop the run, and we couldn't stop the quarterback scramble, and you got to get them in the third down and stop them, and we didn't do that.
One of the big stories in the football game was the return of senior quarterback Austin Sumner. The record-setting signal caller from Brandon made his first action on the field since the season opener at Missouri when he broke bones in his right foot.
Yeah, Austin being able to start made a difference in our energy. But like I tell our players, you know, the pregame speech, the addition to a starting lineup, that lasts about 30 seconds, and you need to come to play, and we did. But you need to come to play internally motivated, and I think we did that.
And Stiglmeyer says that Sumner performed well under the circumstances.
I would say, we don't give him a break because he was out for a while, so I would say a B+, B-, somewhere in the B range. Made some really good throws, made some throws that he wants back, and I want back, but he graded out pretty well.
With number 6 performing as well as he did, he'll be the starting quarterback for Saturday's contest at Indiana State.
Yeah, he felt good after the game and treatments and stuff. He works his tail off trying to get himself ready both in the film room and in the training room, so I expect he would start, and I would expect he'd be that much healthier.
Sumner was not the only man to return from injury on Saturday, however. Wide receiver Jason Schneider did not play against Youngstown State, but he did catch 3 balls in Fargo.
Well, I think the biggest surprise was Jason being able to play. I mean, we all knew it was a process for Austin, but Jason had the injury, and then you're out for this amount of time, and he wasn't. You know, he sat out of practice, but I guess that's the way you like it, sit out of practice and be able to play. But it was good to have him.
Meanwhile, Zach Zenner ran for 90 yards on Saturday. He is now 5th in the FCS annals in career rushing. And he was nominated for the Campbell Trophy last weekend, which is essentially the academic version of the Heisman Trophy.
Yeah, Zach continues to be honored and move up the rushing levels, if you will, in FCS football. This latest award or nomination for the Campbell Trophy is really a special one, and sometimes it gets lost in the football season, but this is one of the top awards in the nation for a college football player.
The Jacks have 3 games left, and with a 5-4 mark, they need to win out and hope it's enough in the eyes of the FCS playoff committee if they are to return to the postseason for the 3rd straight year.
You know, we had some lofty goals, and some of those are maybe gone, but there are some still tangible goals, and the only way we can accomplish those is if we win every play. And it starts in practice, and it starts in the game, and it's coaches and players all coming with a single focus to do my very best in this play, and that's easily measured, and we need to do that.
Saturday's opposition is the Indiana State Sycamores, and what a turnaround Mike Sanford and his program have achieved. A year ago, they won just a single game. Currently, they are 6-3 and in the hunt for an FCS playoff berth.
Well, they had a new coaching staff, and anytime you have a new coaching staff, some people will wait to buy in. You know, I've seen it happen. You change a coach, players wait to buy in. Belief is a decision. It's not something you earn, and I know Coach has done a great job for the last 2 years, but he needed the players to get on his page. They play great defense. They throw the ball around. They're very, very fast on the field. It's a good recipe to have success.
Indiana State has had 3 Missouri Valley football games come down to the wire, decided by a field goal made or missed in the final minute. They even used a trick play in the final minute against Missouri State last Saturday to come away with a 2-point victory.
Well, we do, and we will, and you know, there's no pressure on them. You know, they have 1 win a year ago. They're having a really good year this year, so they're really confident. They walk onto the field with a bounce in their step. You know, we have some pressure. You know, we have lofty goals, expectations and all that stuff, so we will be ready for anything, and hopefully they don't win another close one on Saturday.